Hi, I'm Dr. Garima Khandelwal here. I'm a pediatric dentist practicing in Dubai. I'm making this video as this has been in my mind since a long time, and by God's grace, I'm having the opportunity to do so. So I wish to send out a message and a humble request. I became a pediatric dentist to help especially the differently abled children. I'm from India, and when I had the chance to choose my post-graduation, I cleared my All India Government exam, and I did have other branches to choose to, but I chose pediatric dentistry, and at that time there were just 10 to 12 seats in entire India, and India has a huge population. Pediatric dentistry is a very challenging branch. Children are uncooperative many times, but they do have pain and they need treatment. So a pediatric dentist needs to be very skilled in managing children. But even after you have learned the best of your skills, there are still differently abled children and specially abled children who you cannot manage at all. You have to sedate them and do the treatments. When you talk about sedation, there is an additional hospital cost involved in it. I am from Nair Hospital in Bombay, who's just celebrating its 100th anniversary, and very proud to be a part of that college. Great teachers, amazing college, government college. And while I was doing my post-graduation out there, we saw the most rarest of syndromes in children. We saw the rarest of disabilities. And what struck me was many of these children cannot walk, talk, or do any of the normal bodily activities by themselves. The entire attention of the parents is just focused on cleaning them and, you know, giving them the basic bodily movements which makes them comfortable. And the only way to keep them healthy and alive is to feed. But the entire other bodily functions take away so much of time that it's really difficult to brush so many times for such children. Food often which is given is mashed, and the children cannot chew properly, they cannot swallow properly. Cleaning is the last thing that comes in the mind of these parents, because mandible, this lower jaw, moves. So if you try to brush and there is a strong contraction of the jaw, the child would inadvertently bite very hard, and it's very difficult to brush in such children. Morning, afternoon, evening, food gets stuck for a long period of time, and cavities happen, and before the parents realize it, the cavities are way down in the nerve of the teeth. 2-year-old, 3-year-old, 4-year-old, 12-year-old, same issues. It hurts. Even if you have a small cavity in your own tooth, it hurts. And dental pain is more of a mental pain, because you cannot concentrate on anything else. You have to get it treated. Even as an adult, if you have a pain and you are a normal person, you would go and rush to the dentist because you are having pain. Now just imagine this in a child who's having multiple cavities. He's already having mashed food, and because of the pain, he can't even eat. Then you resort to bottle feeding. Further damage, the permanent teeth are coming. In such scenarios, to find a good pediatric dentist who can deal with such children is very important. Plus, when you visit such a dentist, of course, the dentist is going to say, treatment can be done, yes, but it has to be done under sedation in a hospital setting. The cost is huge, especially in Dubai. The healthcare cost is amazing. Facilities are amazing, and the cost is also wow. I, from my side, by God's grace, have the capacity and the will and the intent to, I want to give back to the society in some way, basically. So in my limit, what I can do is, I wish to do the dental part of the treatment for free for one such child every month. The hospital part has to be paid by the parents, okay? Because hospital charges include general anesthesia cost, OT cost, the consumables cost. That has to be borne by the parents, but the surgeon's fee, that is the dental treatment, the dental materials, everything for one patient once a month, it's on me. I sincerely wish to help. I sincerely wish to be of some help to such parents who genuinely want to get their children treated or their child treated, but cannot do so because of lack of funds. I would like to help more people, and by God's grace, if someday I have the resources to do so, I would just do this. But currently, in my limited situations and circumstances, I would extend this to one child per month. So if you know of any such child or parents who wish to get the dental treatment done under sedation, you can refer to me. I'm Dr. Garima Khandelwal. I'm practicing in Dubai. I would be doing these surgeries in Burjil Hospital in Sharjah. I'm attached to the dental clinics. I have three workplaces. One is Clover Medical Center in TCOM, one is Sultan Al Ulama Center in Al Barsha Mall, and one is True Smile Clinic in Festival City. You can find all about me over my website. I'm pasting my link below. And feel free to email me, or if you feel somebody needs help, but you know, they are, you know how we as parents or middle class people, we don't like to ask for help. It's not embarrassment, it's like, it's a little out of self-respect that we need help, but if somebody offers, we'll take it, but out of our own mouth, we won't ask for it. So if you feel that you know somebody who needs help but can't ask for it, drop me a message. Maybe I'll reach out to them, you know, or just come over and get just a consultation done and understand what it is. And if you're okay with it, like I said, I'll have a waiting list if I am done with one child for that particular month, so I can take the other patient next month. So there, I hope this is of help to someone. Thank you so much.